Yeah, Russian Navy Typhoon class SSB in. The Typhoon class submarine is the largest ballistic missile submarine in the Soviet Union. Far the world's largest human-built submarine. The submarine is a typical product of the Cold War era and designed in order to achieve the principle of mutual assured destruction. Compared with its rival, the U.S. Ohio class, its volume is nearly so twice as bomb protection capabilities inferior to the later equipped with 20 missile launch tubes, loaded SSN 20 ballistic missiles. The range of 8,300 km. The ship is currently the world's largest volume and tonnage of submarines record holder. Holy shit, man. And what is this bending? Oh, what the fuck, man. Okay, it's not supposed to go on now, but I can see there will be some problem here. Look at this. Crap, man. Going fine together here. The rest of the sub is completely fucked. All this end. It's like the sub is going like this. That's in the... You can see here maybe. It's going this way.
Also many fine details here I need to take care of so I not send them. I need to see, is this... They will not stay down there. Okay, now we will. Now we have an option here. I got some photo edit part. And I got the plastic one. What is that? But what is looking best? Let's take a look. The plastic part is not looking bad. Not at all. And when you paint it, it's not something you will see. Oh, someone is broken here. When I cut it off the sprue, it break. They are so fragile and they are actually only holding together with a little bit tiny. And I need to sand all of them. Without break them. And see how easy it is to move. Yeah, they are looking nice in brass, you know that, that's for sure. But the plastic part is looking better. And they also need to turn a little bit. Let's try that. The photo edge part is for many people looking a lot better because they are so much thinner than the plastic part, like my Bismarck with the railings, or in Danish, skrøvlig. They are that is something you will touch so many times before you finish with the model, and I think this will break off. I will not use them. And then before I put them, I'm not sure. You see, if I paint them before I put it in the tubes, maybe they cannot get into the tube. Yeah, good idea. I could smell you, so that is a good idea. Show how they are putting these missiles inside the submarine with a big crane. Doesn't look much as a model, of course, but it is a crazy big submarine. That should be 20. Should fix it somehow. I'll try to put some boiled water over. But I couldn't fix it. I was afraid the boiled water would completely melt the plastic, but it didn't do that. But I know you can use boiled water on really hot water on Warhammer and all kinds of models. And it is a weird kit because weird plastic, because it is like the Tamiya glue is not melting the plastic like you know in Trumpeter Tamiya kits. Academy. This plastic a little bit hard. Somehow it is different anyway. So I'm not sure if now I break one of these two. Not even sure I can get these tubes. To work. They are just sitting. Just need glue in the bottom. What is going to hold those? Let's see that. Nothing. Yeah, okay, if you want this to be close, you could of course drop all the tube and missile. But I think I will go with this open. We need to see. How it is. Oh, here. That is some ring. No, that is not a ring. But that should be something because there is a big hole here. This cannot be. Look at this. You can see right down in the kit. That cannot be. Must be something. If there is not something I can put there, it would look really awful. There is only this. Seriously. If this is this kid is really really hitting me now. If this just is going to sit something like this, it is looking so bad. I know the fit is really bad right now, but just to show you what the fuck is going on here. If the door is open, this is what you see. Yeah. You do that. Let's take a look. Fürstenfeldbruck. There it is. Need a little bit of thin to me here. It is going together so bad. So bad.
How can I do that? Let's see. Okay. It's an old one. Let's see, we can do this. I need some super glue here. The talking submarine. Let's see if we can super glue. And now I have actually got some activator. Maybe we should try that now. I put it in a Tamir bottle. Okay, something weird's happening here. And in a minute say poof. What I'm trying to look at now, because it is now I need to decide if I want to, that I have no more plastic. I have tubes and missile. That's it. Then I have the superstructure. I'm going to sit here, so I have some stuff sitting here. This big hole will be there. This is also why I didn't sand these. Come on. That was nice. Maybe if all the tubes will be there, you don't see it so much, I don't know. But for now I will not glue this on. I need to see how this is working. If it looked like crap, I will close this up. Let me close this up, that's for sure. Come down and see.
It's a little bit weird, yeah? That's the way it will look.
What a cheesy way of making a kit. They could have made some wall. I could also make by myself, but I don't have extra plastic. Now they maybe cannot be here because of this. Of course not. Twenty missiles. If you make a water diorama or something, that could be nice. I don't want to use Taiwan diorama or all kinds of stuff on this kit here. If it has been a good kit, I could maybe. Every 10 minutes or 5 minutes or something. Can't remember how much it is. Now this part is on, so we can break some antenna, you know. Let me show you if I can. 2 seconds. There is nothing with this kit that is going together as it's supposed to. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, it should be straight, but I can't see. My eyes need to focus when you use this. Holy fuck. Okay. Here it is. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.